On paper, 1 divided by 137 looks like a basic maths operation that can be solved by a fifth grader with the help of a scientific calculator. Within a few seconds of computing, you should arrive at the decimal equivalent of the fraction, which is 0.00729735256. It sounds all easy-peasy, but in reality, this math phenomenon known as the fine structure constant is the foundation of one of the biggest unsolved mysteries in physics, one that great scientists like Richard Feynman and Laurence have been unable to solve. But what exactly does this strange constant mean? And why is it so perplexing to scientists? The fine structure constant is a popular figure in physics. It's present in quantum equations and powers most of the other existing laws of physics, including Planck's constant, the gravitational constant, and the speed of light. Scientists in the field of quantum mechanics are quite obsessed with it, yet it remains one of the least understood concepts in physics. English theoretical physicist Paul Adrian Maurice described it as the most fundamental unsolved problem in physics. His Austrian colleague, Wolfgang Ernst Pauli, promised to ask the devil what the fine structure constant is when he dies. American physicist Richard Phillips Feynman wasn't left out either. He pondered this weird constant throughout his life until the 15th of February 1988. In fact, 3 years before his death, Richard Feynman was quoted saying, "All good theoretical physicists put this number up on their wall and worry about it." But what exactly is there to worry about in a simple fraction operation, and why are physicists so concerned about it? We'll explain, but before we get into it, let's get some background on the fine structure constant that's not so structured. Like most concepts in physics, the discovery of the weird constant was made while scientists were observing the movement made by light particles as electrons flipped between different energy levels in atoms. Consequently, this results in the emission of photons of specific energies that can be viewed as spectral lines. Spectral lines are light produced by transitions of electrons within atoms or ions of different wavelengths. Understanding spectral lines was key to the development of quantum mechanics. It also helped us understand hydrogen lines through the Bohr model and also the Schrödinger equation for heavier elements. But despite these successes, scientists still had problems with the concept. With the advent of better measurement apparatus, it became obvious that the single spectral lines were not properly aligned with the calculated values. Furthermore, it was discovered that every single line consists of two lines at similar but not quite identical energies. The German physicist Arnold Sommerfeld shed more light on the theory by using the effects of the general law of relativity by Albert Einstein and the concept of electron spin, which postulates that the energy levels of electrons with opposite spins are slightly separated by their interaction with their own orbital magnetic fields. According to Sommerfeld's submission, the difference in energy between the fine line was a constant that's a multiple of one particular number. Constants of these sorts are not rare in physics. We see them across several topics and equations. However, the fine structure constant is different in the sense that it doesn't have an SI unit. Sounds weird, right? Of course it does. As a standard, the charge of electrons is measured in coulombs, and the speed of light is measured in meters per second. The Planck's constant and vacuum permittivity also have their assigned units. However, when you combine all of these units, they completely cancel out themselves. And somehow we're left with a pure number, 1/137th, or 1/137.0359993. This is what we've come to know as the fine structure constant. The weird thing is, the number doesn't only appear in the equation for the fine structure separation of spectral lines. For instance, we know that the repulsive energy between two electrons is 137 times smaller than a photon with a wavelength equal to the distance between the electrons. At the same time, in the Bohr model, the orbital speed of an electron in the ground state is about 137 times slower than the speed of light. The way that the different ratios of properties work out results in 1/137th or 137 to some kind of twisting power. Is this number giving us hints about some weird theories in the universe? It looks like it, but even after several decades since Sommerfeld made his submission, scientists still can't explain the mystery of the fine structure constant. To be fair, there have been some close calls. For one, the Feynman diagrams show us the interaction between particles. These diagrams are used to calculate the probabilities of particles interacting and the numerous ways in which they can happen. Essentially, these probabilities depend on a few factors like the masses, spin, charges, momenta, and the particles' positions. In turn, these factors multiply some sort of base probability that either makes the interaction more likely to happen or not. Here, the base probability is derived from the coupling constant or coupling strength for the interaction. And considering that the fine structure constant is the coupling strength of the electromagnetic force, the greater the probability of interaction between the electron and electromagnetic fields, the more of an EM disturbance each electron will cause. This perhaps explains why the fine structure constant is widely used with equations that depend on electromagnetism. But it doesn't explain why alpha has the value it does, or why the specific combination of other fundamental constants equates to alpha. It seems like the fine structure constant isn't constant after all. It changes based on the energy of the interaction. In other words, the higher the energy, the larger the constant. According to estimates, the crazy energies, or the coupling constant for the EM field combined with other forces produced right after the Big Bang, would have been close to 1. But consequently, it dropped tremendously to lower values as the energy was reduced and the forces separated. We're at the base of the energy scale, and the fine structure constant has bottomed out at 1/137.035999. But why stop at this strange minimum value? Why didn't it drop all the way to 0? Well, it's actually better off this way because there would have been no electromagnetism if alpha was equivalent to 0. This means we literally wouldn't have atoms or fridge magnets, amongst other things. Assuming this constant had a greater value, electrons would be closer to nuclei, meaning they would be tightly bound and less likely to take part in chemical bonds. On the other hand, if the value was smaller, electrons would be bound loosely, meaning atoms and molecules would be less stable. All of these illustrations show just how important and ironic the fine structure constant is. Indeed, some theorists believe that if the value had been a few percent different, carbon would not have formed inside stars, and life as we know it today would have been impossible. Nobody knows for sure how the universe created the fine structure constant, or most of the other fundamental constants. Physicists tend to believe that they were randomly handpicked by the universe itself. But in any case, it seems to have selected the right value to support the existence of life. But that's not even the strangest thing about this constant. The more confusing thing about this figure is that it's dimensionless. For instance, let's say there's a way to transmit a short message to another civilization. How do you specify that the message is sent from an intelligent species? One way to do this would be to show your knowledge of physics by using the different constants of nature. But the problem with that is that many of these constants have their own units of measurement. So if you're sending, let's say, the value of the speed of light, which is 299,792,458 meters per second, you'd also have to explain what meters per second means. In the same way, if you transmitted Planck's constant, you would have to explain to the aliens on the other side what a kilogram is, because that's the only way they would properly understand the message. Interestingly, the fine structure constant is not tied to a particular unit of measurement. Regardless of the planet or universe, it's 1/137th. But for all we know, it's not the only unitless. You can get tons of unitless numbers by rationing two numbers with the same unit of measurement. However, the fine structure constant is different in the sense that it is unitless and ubiquitous. If you consider other fundamental constants of nature that have measurement units, it's easy to understand what the constant means. By studying the units, we're also able to learn that the constants of nature represent relationships. And there are several examples to show it, like the speed of light, which ratios the dimensions of space and time in relativity, and also shows the relationship between mass and energy in Einstein's theory of general relativity. In the same way, the gravitational constant depicts the relationship between mass, distance, and gravitational force. Just as Planck's constant shows the relationship between the uncertainty when measuring position and velocity, we can go on and on. But since the fine structure constant doesn't have a unit, it's hard to tell what type of relationship it defines or represents. But thinking about it again, this strange constant could actually be a relationship between other relationships. Based on this, we could assume that if the other constants of nature link various physical parameters, then maybe the fine structure constant is what connects the constants together. Also, the fact that the fine structure constants link many physical aspects of the universe together should have given us enough hints of the mechanisms that set the values for constants after the Big Bang. It could also suggest that there may be a deeper connection between the properties of the elementary particles, including the mass and charge of electrons. Alternatively, it could be that the fine structure constant is not a physical constant like we think. Rather, it might just be a physical constant like pi, but we don't know it yet because our mathematics is not yet at that level. Theoretically, it looks like to build a universe from scratch, one would need a constant from which other constants of nature would be derived. In our case, this constant was 1/137th, or the fine structure constant, which has laid the foundation for all other fundamental constants that exist in our universe.